KLM has been informed by the Dutch team assisting in the investigations of the cause of the collision at Los Rodillos Airport that according to the voice recorder of the airport control tower, it appears that no explicit clearance for takeoff was given to the captain. It's inconceivable to KLM that the captain would have taken off if he'd known that clearance had not yet been given. In order to get a clear picture of the cockpit crew's proceedings, it will first be necessary to listen to the cockpit voice recorder of the KLM aircraft. It is possible that an explanation could be obtained from this. Due to the fact that the highly specialized equipment necessary is not available, it will not be possible to do this at Tenerife. As yet, the voice recorder, the cockpit voice recorder, is being held by the Spanish authorities. The Dutch investigation team considers the information gained up to now insufficient for any conclusions and will therefore continue its work in collaboration with the Spanish Commission and the American investigation team.
Based on this statement, is it conceivable to you that even though your pilot was told that he was free to hold but not to proceed any further, he might have said, no, I have to take off? How do you explain this? This is a direct conflict in the explanation of why this happened. It's very clear-cut, the fact that he was told he was given clearance only to hold. He was not given clearance to take off, and if he did, it would have to be an error on his part, would it not?
You are using words which are unfamiliar to me. In the transcript that has been read to me of the recording, the word hold is not being used.
We have press reports in America, wire reports, that in fact that is the language used by the Spanish investigating committee, that they said they gave your pilot permission to hold but not to take off.
Prior to that, there was a word which might stipulate, and I put it very carefully, which might be interpreted by crew that they were given clearance to take off. And that's all I'd like to say at this point in time. This is one side of the story. The other side might well have been on the cockpit voice recorder, the communication between the pilot and his co-pilot, and on the other hand, communication between the aircraft and the tower.